So let's start how to write strings. First of all, again, we will go here and start type Python. We'll open our favorite IDLE. This should be the first thing I feel when you're learning Python, you should open it. When we are doing advanced Python, then you can use IPython. I'll show you at the last lecture, like how IPython looks and how it is more advanced than this IDLE, and very, it is very easy and comfortable. There are many options in that to execute it. So let us write how the string works. For example, we know the variable. For example, name equals to Sumit. If age equals to 2, let's see type of name, the string, and type of age is int. I remember, first let us go to how we write strings, and then after that we can check the type conversion. Badraksh has one doubt yesterday, so we will also cover that. If I write like this, for example, sometime I need to print, try to print always in single quotes. You can take one standard, either single quotes or double quotes. So first thing is to write name equals to Sumit. So this is also a string, name equals to Sumit. This is also a string. Okay, what we can do is that now name equals to Sumit. Let's put name in double quotes and surname equals to Pandit. When we do type name, it is string. Okay, I didn't get put surname in single quotes. And then we put type surname. Last lecture we saw how type works. Now is instance work. If you are not aware of that, I can repeat one more time. Like, type shows what kind of object type you are working on. So int is like numbers, floats, and all, etc. And here the name and surname is string. So when I wrote string in double quotes, it also worked. And when I wrote it in single quotes, then also it worked. For example, I can type one sentence. So let our sentence be, we are going to grammars again, what we did in our high school. So if I say Ram is going to home, okay, when I write this and I do print sentence, it works. But if I write like this, sentence equals to, now when I write in single quotes, this is most important. No? You will find many of the programmers struggling with this. Sometimes you have to debug how it went. You can see here when you type in IDLE, so whatever is in green is going to be printed. But what happened is that after this, everything went blank. So in string, there are two things. One is opening, it might be double quotes or single quotes, and then there is closing. So there has to be two quotes. So what happened is that if you are starting with single quote, then end with single quote only. If you are starting with double quote, then end with double quote only. So here what I'm doing is that I'm starting with single quotes, but what has happened is after this, it has ended. So string is still here only. And from here, it is Python is taking as a variable. So if you end it here, like if I type it from school, okay. So even here it is single, it is opening quote and closing quote. And this will take this also string, but this one goes wrong. So let me now enter it, it will say syntax error, because the thing is that when we did it in double quotes, so double quotes, this was the starting and this was the ending double quote, and in between this you can write it, because if you are starting with double quotes and with double quotes, in between you put how many. So let us take again in this one example. if you take any single quotes, it will work. Okay. So again, let me try to enter it. It will work. But in this case, if you put double quotes here, it will not work. It will throw an error because what we started here, it got closed here. And this one, this is like, it's alone. It's alone in the sentence. We don't have to leave what is starting to be as alone. So same is happening here. So to resolve this, what Python provides you is the backslash. So instead of whatever you put in backslash, this one, this is backslash. Yeah. So we have a lot of confusion in forward slash and backslash. So whatever you put after backslash, it escapes it. It doesn't count it. It will print like this only. So for now, remember, if you're writing anything in single quote, and if you want to write like Ram is going to school in single quote, just use backslash before is. Okay. Now let me print sentence. It works. Another thing is like, if you want to like sometime print new line. So new line is slash n in Python like this. So if I say, suppose I want to write a big sentence, this sentence, I want to split it into two. Ram is going to home. And after that, he's going to attend tuition. So if I write like this, Ram is going to home. And now I want that it should be new line after which it should print. So what I write here is backslash n. Let me type after that. He will go to tuition. I don't know if tuition spelling is right or wrong. It should be right. Okay. So you can see here where we put slash n, after that new line started. Just like when we write any diary or when we give exam, we need to write couple of lines. And even after this, if you do slash n, okay, we'll have to copy this. I can't edit this. Slash and then you put he will eat ice cream after finishing tuition. Okay. So this became three line. So wherever you will put slash in, it will become three line. Sometime you need to add tab. So tab, I can show you. I'll show new line and tab only because we don't have that much time, but you can look at the net and see what all kind of things you can put. There are many things like tab, carriage return, bytes, but tab and new lines are important. Print, if I do like this, okay, Ram. For tab, remember T for tab and T. So you put like backslash t, and for new line it's backslash n, so you can remember new line then n. For tab, do it t. Ram, Shyam, Raju and Sita, Geeta. So here it is like this, Ram, Shyam. So we see we have the space between this is called as tab. So you are proper spacing it like this. After this, let us see some of the operations in string. We'll go to files also, which we have in how to open files in Windows, but we'll go at the last. First we'll complete strings. Okay. So for example, I have a string. Let us see, I have a string like SUMITENDIT. Okay. Home name equals to. Okay. So if I do len of name Len is the function. So you can remember len as length. When you want to calculate length of any string, just use len. So just relate it, length, len. What we type it here is 12. You can see here, this is 5 and this is 6. 5 plus 6, 11, and between this space is also been calculated. For example, let us take another name. I'll take from participants. Okay, let me take Bhadrash Bhargava. Okay, yeah, we will do that, Bhadrash, wait. So if we have, okay, let us BHAD, okay, SHABM. Now, what are total letters in his full name? Let us do it. It is 18, and if you remove space, so total character will be 17. Another operation is concatenation, which Bhadrash has asked the question. So let me do it as name equals to, we'll take this only. Okay, and surname equals to Bhargava. Okay, so what we do after this is, let us just like do name plus surname. It is printing without space. So to add space, what we will do? Just add and then surname. So we have Bhadrash Bhargava. And also, like, if I want to, what is the name Bhadrash? Like, if I want to like repeat it like 10 times in Python, it is very simple. Just do it, print name into 10. So we have 10 times Bhadrash. Or what we can do is that full name. So Bhadrash. Or apart from that, name plus, let me check this, it works or not. No, it doesn't work. So what we can do is that, to take its space as name equals to, we are reassigning the variable. In this, you see what we are doing is that name is Bhadrash. And what we are doing, we are concatenating Bhadrash with one space. So now name is Bhadrash and here we have one space remaining. So now let us print name into 20 times. So see, we have printed here. So this is repetition. And also, like, for example, sometime you might ask input and all, etc. to your users. For last time when we ran this guess game, where is guess game? It is in C code. Yeah, so let's add it with Python ID. Okay, I'll not run this game again, but what you can do it here is that print, this is simple to make your code look beautiful, and after that let us print it here. Let's see how it works. So star and all, etc. What you had in multiplication, so you are using it here like this only. This is the multiplication symbol. But when we add single quotes in front of it, so it becomes a string. Let us put it here dash. I think dash would be great. Dash is also minus symbol, but here we are using this. So this is called operator overloading. You might have heard jargon like, what is operator overloading? This is the simplest example to in Python, how you use operator overloading. Those who are starting it, don't get confused. Just remember, this is operator overloading where you're using multiplication symbol as a string. This is one example. Now let us run this. So this is the kind of output you can, we have not used this in the, most of the time my answer would be wrong, so better. Six. Okay, so this is like this. You have redesigned the interface rather than simple input. Now what we can take is other thing is like other operation, Okay, one more thing. So last time what we did was, so whatever comes in input, for example, let us take a number one for last time our script and input, enter the number, okay, enter the number between any number, okay, from 1 to 6, number you want to add, enter first number. Now what we do is here is that we ask num1, let me enter the number 5, and what we do here is num1, what is type of num1? It's a string. So when you will try to do the addition of number 1 in your script, it will be error. So what it says is there is error, must be string, not int. Okay, so the problem is that this is int. If we do just type of 1, it is int, okay, but what is the type of num1? It's string, so we will not be able to add it. So if we want to do the addition, so that's why we put up num num1 and plus 1, so it becomes 6, because now we have converted here into string. For example, what we can do is type int num1, so it has become int. So you can add numbers and numbers only, you cannot add alphabets and numbers, so this we should keep in mind. And apart from that, if you want to print like 51, so int, you can do it like strings num1, num1 is already string because whatever input we are taking, just convert your 1 to string, so it is 51, so I converted this to string. So this is one of the type which you need to put it up. Yeah, however, you can ask it out, you can chat in, I'll see. Apart from this, what we can do is that we can put some indexing. So for example, our name is Bhadrash, and let us do it at full name equals to name plus surname. Okay, so full name is Bhadrash. So what I want is that I just want to take the first character of the, let us see, you have a name, for example, let us see what is the length of name, 10. Okay, so what you want is that from full name you want to just extract the name. So if we do is that full name, okay, let us see what is the full name. 0 B, full name 1, it is H. Yeah, no, num1 is actually whatever we are taking at as an input. When you write input on the screen, and whatever the user types in, so the type of that is string. But what we want is that when we are writing the program to add numbers or like do the addition of two numbers, so instead of like here, we can see here it is type num1, it is a string, but what we want is that we want to addition. So in our like basic class also, we will not be able to add a plus 1, right, because a is a string and 1 is different. So instead of that, what we need to do is that we need to convert the output what we have from the input function into int. If we put this kind of function, then it will convert into int, and then you can do your basic mathematical operations. So we were here like full name and full name 0. So anything that starts, you might see that this B is at first position, H is at second position, A is at third position, D is at fourth position. But in Python, everything starts from 0. So here we have B is at 0 position. So you can imagine, I don't have, okay, I will try to draw, but I don't know it will work or not. So we'll do it just simple. Okay. Okay. So, oh no, this is really bad. Okay, but still, if I will take smaller name, which is mine, okay, so if you can imagine this as Sumit in computer's memory or Python's memory. I think this lecture will take more time. So what we can do is that we can take half today, and in next lecture we can do string operations. Okay, so what is like S position? It is like, we might think, those who are new in programming, but those who are older, they know. So we might think this as a first position, second position, third position, fourth position, fifth position. But in Python, when you write a variable in a string, so this becomes zero position, this becomes first position, this becomes second position, this becomes third position, and this becomes fourth position. So always remember, whenever you type anything in your string as a variable, so it will start from zero. So if I take, so if I take here name equals to Sumit, okay, so if I do it at name zero, it is S. As you can see here, S is zero. And if I take it as name one, U, and name two, S I M, name three, S I, name four, S T. If I do it here as name zero, suppose I want only sum, I don't want I and T. So what I can do it here as, so if I want sum, so if I want sum, so only sum. So what I would need the element, I need element from 0, 1 and 2. So it would be, okay, 0 to 2 means it will print here till this only. We need 0 to 3. Always remember, it will take the first element and it will do the last element minus 1. So if you have put here 3, it will be 3 minus 1, 2. So 0, if you want to print till M, you'll have to include this. So it will be like this. When it does the slicing, what it does is here is that it will be 0. It will be 1. It will be 2. And it will be 3. So when you have done from 0 to 3, it has printed sum. So if you want to print like 0 to 4, and this is 5. Okay, so if you want to print like till I, so you can do it like name as 0 to 4, and for every element 0 to 5, total length of element, if I say length of name is 5. But writing 0 to 5 is not convenient. You can just write like this only. This, what does this mean? This means you can take every element. Yeah, this is a con. In the string, it's not an array, but when you see it in the memory, it is kind of an put in an array type only for the string in Python. So after that, what we have done the slicing. You can go more and read on the internet about slicing. So array is different thing in Python, it's called list. But when we are seeing this in memory strings, it should be seen as an array, because when we are doing slicing, so we have done concatenation, we have done slicing, we have also converted, added like string to int. Now also what we can do is that, suppose you want to see like what does S means in, so these are ASCII bits and all. We are not covering Unicode here, but the thing is that Unicode is very important. So those who are new to programming, just remember, because of Unicode, you are able to see every language in your mobile and PC when you go to Chinese website, Japanese or Russian. So because of Unicode, we are able to do this. But for example, if you want to see like what S contains in the binary in Unicode, so it is like this. Just use odd command and do yes. You can play with it. What is A? And odd A is different. Yeah, append would come in list. So this is string. So after that also what I can do here is that for example, let us take my full name as, so I only have 7 minutes remaining. I can take some of the things and bit part will take in next lecture. So if you have Sumit Pandit, let me do this as, so what I want to do is that I want to replace Sumit with Arjun Pandit. Okay. So full name is, and after that, what I, if I need to take out like total full name, I will do it at 026. Okay. Okay. Full is not defined. We can do it at 026. It is like Sumit. Now, if I want to replace my full name with Sumit with, just do replace, and here I can do it like write Arjun, and what I want to replace is like Sumit. Okay, why didn't work? Just a second. Full name dot replace Sumit Arjun. Okay, so what do you want to replace? Like I want to replace Sumit with Arjun. So I just wrote full name dot replace Sumit and Arjun. So here it, the full name was Sumit. Now here the full name is Arjun Pandit. So you can use replace command to do it many things. For example, let us take example of string, and let me write A dollar, B dollar, C dollar, D dollar dollar, and E again dollar. Okay, so now what I can do is that, this is very important command, replace dollar with star. See, we have replaced it. Now again, one more thing, sometimes like you might get the string as example sumit comma, this is very important command, comma, then another thing is, let me do it, then Pune, then Mumbai. Now what you want to do is that you want to take every element, like, so you will not go and do like formatting like this to do every element in this case. For example, string, then 0 to 5 to get Sumit. Okay, what you can simply do is that string dot split. Okay, we can write it here, we can put this in variable values equals to string dot split. So let us see what values are Sumit. So whatever you can see here, comma. So what we have done is that we have split means we have taken every part of the string where comma exists, and we have like split it up and taken every variable in it. So if we can do it here like this, values 0, values 1. So we know first is Sumit, second is Uday, like this only. Even string is like this, string equals to Sumit Uday Pandit. Then we can do like this, string dot split. Now here you will not find comma, here comma is not there, but what is there is space. So I'll do it like this. Let me type here it as full name. Okay, full name equals to Sumit Uday Pandit. Now let us see what full name is. Full name is three values: Sumit, Uday, Pandit. So this is first name, this is middle name, this is last name, surname. So if I do it like this, name equals to full name zero. So what is name? Middle name equals to full name one. So what is middle name? Okay, and same like surname would be second element, 0, 1, 2. So we will stop here. In next lecture we will see some more string examples, and we can also find list if we have time. Okay, thank you guys. If you have any question, like ping me in. I have 2 minutes still remaining in this software. So if anyone has doubt, please ask.
Hello. Yeah, I am Madraksh.
Thanks, Upnil.
So I want to create a program which it displays the half of my name.
Yeah, Madraksh, we are not
like my name has 80. Hello, are you able to hear me now?
You can type it, Madraksh. We are not able to hear you. I know your question is like how I can add two strings like A equals to Madraksh and B equals to Bhargava. I have shown it here, like full name in this case. I showed it with your example only. Where it is. So we have name equals to Madraksh and surname equals to Bhargava. We added name plus surname like this. It was more earlier. If we see here, yeah, name plus surname, and with the space in between, it's Madraksh. Name we put it up Madraksh, surname Bhargava, and here. Okay, guys, I'm ending this session here. If you have any doubt, you can just mail me or ping me. I will see if I have time, I can resolve it. And in next session, we'll again go with little bit more string, and then we can go with advanced object types. Thank you, everyone. Thanks a lot. Thanks.